It's pretty. welcome the Personnel and Industrial Relations Officer of the San Fernando City Corporation, Ms. Yvette Russo. Good evening, Ms. Russo. Welcome. Now, we are in the city of San Fernando this evening, and we are in the San Fernando City Corporation Auditorium. It's only fitting that we ask the Deputy Mayor, Ms. Vidya Mungabisesa, to bring remarks. Please welcome the Deputy Mayor of the City of San Fernando.
After coming to bring remarks after a performance like that, I mean, that's not very fair. Good night, everybody. Forgive me if I'm a little slow on the salmon t-shirts because I'm not looking at it. And I'm asking for forgiveness up front in this season of festivity and holidays. If I miss anybody, forgive me up front. But let's see. Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Rural Development and Local Government, Ms. Destra Bascom. And Mr. Bascom, Senior Superintendent of Municipal Police, Mr. Carlisle Huggins and Mrs. Huggins, Deputy Chairman of the SASC, Mr. Kenneth Parker, Director of OLP, Mr. Keith Renault and Mrs. Renault, and all the other, I think Mrs. Santana walking shortly while I was here. Nice to see you in the South again, sir. To my public relations office, head of personnel, PIRO, Ms. Russo, and all the many officers, whatever your rank, your lovely companions, your wives, your kids, your friends, your family, all of you who are here, greeting my ASP. I forgot, please, the San Fernando Municipal Police, the wonderful, the incomparable ASP and the Reverend. It is my honor and my pleasure to bring greetings to you. And I'm not going to be very long, but I have my own personal bias when it comes to the municipal police. Because I have been in San Fernando in our council for 4 years now, 4 years and some change, first as an alderman, now as deputy mayor and councillor. And I have seen the hard work, the dedication that our municipal police officers put out every single day. I've seen them. I have seen them come off of being on vacation, come off of sick leave to facilitate programs that we may have to benefit those who are differently abled or those who are needy in our society when we have things on, or to be there for special functions, and it delights my heart to no end to see them in their lovely white uniforms lined up at the front of the auditorium whenever we have official functions. You love it, you know exactly what I'm talking about. The other thing is, I've seen them put their own lives at risk, and I know from all the different municipalities or police officers, forgive me if I say the wrong thing, but I've never been known for being coy. What you see is what you get. What I think is what I see. I think that they are shortchanged. You all are shortchanged to some great extent. Because for some reason, the public of Trinidad and Tobago seems to assume, and many of its senior personnel seem to assume, that our municipal officers are somehow less than what they consider real police. And in my small way, I want to encourage all persons. There are very few who will hear my voice here, but I say it every chance I get on the outside. And encourage those of my, well, I'm a little fish, but encourage those of my level and the bigger fish to please put the word out there. They are no lesser than anybody else. They are as dedicated, as committed, as hardworking, and as trustworthy as any other real police. Season when sometimes
sometimes it becomes a silly season, although I think the one coming up is really the silly season. But sometimes when people turn it into the silly season, I want to remind everyone it isn't the silly season. It's a season when we stop and we reflect and we think of the things and we prioritize the things that are most important to us. And that is the camaraderie, the love, the family, whether it be by blood, by heart, or by jaw. And we understand these are the things that are important in life. Enjoy the rest of tonight. It's my honor, my pleasure to be here and join with you. And one of my colleagues, Dr. Levin Smith, who is the chairman of our Security and Disaster Management Committee here at San Fernando, is here. And wish you all everything that God would wish for you, because sometimes we want more than He expects for us. But I wish you happiness, I wish you hope, I wish you love, I wish you a sense of togetherness, and most of all, that we continue to make this beautiful Twin Island Republic of ours, Trinidad and Tobago, the most beautiful place in the world. Merry Christmas and a bright, prosperous 2018.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Vidya Mungo Bisesa, Deputy Mayor of the City of San Fernando. Certainly a glowing tribute to the Municipal Police. Let's hear it for the Deputy Mayor again. This time, we take the honor of inviting the Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Rural Development and Local Government, Ms. Destra Bascom, to bring remarks. P.S. Bascom.
Thank you very much, my good friend and colleague, Mr. Kiltif, for having an enjoyable moment at the Ministry of National Security when we worked together a few years ago. Good night, ladies and gentlemen, and season's greetings. When I walked in the room, I really thought I was at the Academy Awards or the Emmy Awards. Everyone looked so fantastic, both the ladies and the gents. Give yourself a round of applause. You have beautiful weather, and you look wonderful. Okay, Deputy Mayor, Ms. Mungo Bisesa, Deputy Mayor of the wonderful city of San Fernando. Remark there. Assistant Commissioner, the one and only Brian Headley, now based at our own head office at Kent House, and Mrs. Headley. Senior Superintendent Caroline Huggins, based in San Fernando, and Mrs. Huggins. And the wonderful Lord who gave us such a wonderful rendition of Gee Whiz Christmas. Just put you on notice, Mr. Keeper, my former colleague and current colleague, because I will share a secret with you. We have been doing wonderful work in recruiting municipal police. And my two colleagues, Mr. Balfour and Mr. Reno, they play an integral part in that process. I'll share a bit with you later on that. I'm also bearing in mind that the only thing standing between you and dinner is me, so I will not talk very long. Mr. Kenneth Parker, Deputy Chairman of the SASC, welcome. It's good to have you here, another key stakeholder, because I hope you are all aware that SASC recently advertised the position of Municipal Police Constable, and they will begin the recruitment process January 12th, and it's being zoned. So they start off with policy, and then they will be going to the various boroughs and cities, Arima, Point Fortin, and San Fernando. The Public Service Commission has also started the recruitment process, and I'll share a bit with you on that later. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm standing in here for our Minister, Senator, the Honorable Kazim Hussein, who who came earlier and will be joining us at some point before the final curtain is down. He is at another engagement in the city of San Fernando, and he will be joining us shortly. What am I sharing with you today? Usually I like to share the reform of local government, which is a manifesto promise and it is a government promise. We have reached the brink of 2018, and 2018 is when we will start the implementation of local government reform. We have had 2 years of planning. The draft policy on local government reform was approved by cabinet in September of 2016. We have had a task force working on various implementation strategies for the past year, and we are working closely with the Ministry of the Attorney General and Legal Affairs to draft the legislative aspects which would enable true reform. But in the meantime, while we wait for the legislative drafting, we will be doing some quick wins in terms of implementing the reform, because we are looking at the reform as something which will take a phased approach for implementation. But there are certain aspects of the Municipal Corporations Act which can be implemented without legislative changes. For instance, some of the simple building applications, if you need to build a single dwelling unit, that could be done through the Municipal Corporations. And there are various other aspects of the Municipal Corporations Act which can be implemented. So last week we sent a note to Cabinet in order to update the Cabinet on what are the plans for implementing the reform in beginning in 2018. Now, municipal police, we cannot have local government reform without a reformed municipal police service. And with that in mind, Cabinet in January of 2017 approved the creation of 1,107 additional positions of municipal police, ranging from constable right up to superintendent. We have begun the recruitment process for the municipal police constable in the Public Service Commission. That will be the 9 regional corporations plus Chabonas Power Corporation, and the SASE has started their process. When the position was advertised back in March of this year, over 4,000 persons applied for the position. We set an exam and almost 500 persons passed. We have just completed, and I really mean just, within the past 10 days, we've completed the interview process, and the next stage will be the psychometric testing, the physical testing, and then a 4-month period of training. So it is expected that after Easter, we will see the passing out of the first batch of newly recruited municipal police constables. And I know some of your numbers are short. Some of the corporations only have 9 municipal police, 5 municipal police. So this will go a long way to supplementing your ranks. But even before the passing out of this first batch, based on the new positions, we expect to have a passing out parade about the 3rd week in January, depending on funding and other logistical arrangements, of 26 newly recruited municipal police constables. They have been recruited in the whole system through the Service Commission Department, one of our other key stakeholders. So we have that to look forward to. And it is expected that each corporation would have a maximum of 100 new municipal police officers, with the exception of Portland, which will have a maximum of 200. For obvious reasons, they are the city and they have a larger area to cover. So if you currently have 9 municipal police within your region, you will get an additional 91. If you have 95, but if there's anybody with 95, then you will only get 5. It's a maximum of 100 per municipality. So ladies and gentlemen, I've heard a lot of pearls of wisdom tonight. Work harder, work smarter, and I want to piggyback on what Mr. Reno mentioned, that you know you should view yourselves and have the public view you, not as market police. But when you hear municipal police, you know a lot of the officers will be doing market policing. we see you as community police, where you will be part of the reform, part of the change, and every assist the TTPS, our brothers and sisters of the TTPS, get the crime rate down. Look at not only the homicide rate, not only the serious crimes, but also the simple crimes as well. And I'd like to take a plug here for a new committee which we have started, the National Crime Prevention Program. You'll be hearing more about that in January, where we plan to have a lot of stakeholder consultations. There's an oversight committee, of which I am the deputy chair. It's a collaborative approach between the Ministry of National Security, the Ministry of Rural Development and Local Government, and we have stakeholders from a range of ministries, including Social Development, Education, the Tobago House of Assembly, Ministry of Planning, the Ministry of Sport and Youth Affairs, the Ministry of Works. So it's a whole of government approach in order to reduce crimes and maintain the high standards that we know and love about our beautiful Twin Island Republic. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a lot in store 2018. We are hitting the ground running come January 2nd, and we can only do this together. I know you are passionate about your job, and someone spoke about prosperity. We cannot waste a good crisis, ladies and gentlemen. As PS, that is how I will phrase it. We may not have all the resources at our disposal, but in any crisis, we can do more with less. We can find creative ways of getting the job done. We can collaborate with other ministries which may have more resources than us. And it may not only be financial resources, ladies and gentlemen. It could be personnel. Somebody may have a building which you can have a function in at no cost. For instance, this venue here, courtesy of the San Fernando City Corporation. I'm just putting a plug. So ladies and gentlemen, let's not waste this good crisis that is happening in terms of the economy. Let us maximize it, do more with less, so that we can have a better Trinidad and Tobago. And with these few words, ladies and gentlemen, enjoy the rest of the season, enjoy the rest of the night, and be safe on the road, because I expect to see each and every one of you bright and early on the job Tuesday morning. Enjoy the long weekend.
Thank you very much, Ms. Destra Bascom, Permanent Secretary of Ministry of Rural Development and the Local Government. Certainly a wide-ranging and informative address. Let's give another round of applause to the Municipal Police. And everything there is thanks. And to deliver the vote of thanks this evening, we invite the captain of the ship, Assistant Commissioner Brian Headley, Municipal Police of Tobago. Pleasant evening to all. Nice, Merry Christmas. The pleasure is mine to give thanks on this auspicious occasion. And indeed it is auspicious, it is the first of its kind among the ranks of the Municipal Police Service, newly formed Municipal Police Service, I must say. And I want to start with the chairman, Mr. Curtis Belfour. He's also the deputy director of the Office of Law Enforcement Policy. And he has been doing a wonderful job, don't you think so?
Yeah.
I want to especially thank him for his contribution at the Office of Law Enforcement Policy as it relates to the job that he has been doing along with his director towards the development and bringing the municipal police where they are today. So I would dearly like to thank him very much for his contribution, not only as chairman in the nice proceeding, but also his contribution at the Office of Law Enforcement
policy. And I prefer to go in order, not necessarily in order of protocol, but in order as the speakers who came up on the podium. And I thank WP Inspector Mahapia for that wonderful word of prayer. We thank you very much for your words, Ms. Mahapia. And our dear Senior Superintendent, Mr. Kallis. Okay. Now I say Kallis, and I know you say Kallai. You ever see the spelling of Kallis or Kallai? No, it's confusing. It sounds, if you go to the spelling, it sounds like Kallis, but it's really pronounced Kallai. So you know, jokingly I say Kallis, and at times I say Kallai. I'd like to thank you very much for that open remarks, Mr. Huggins, and we surely appreciate your words of encouragement. Mr. Kenneth Parker, Deputy Chairman of the Statutory Authority Service Commission. Mr. Parker has been flying the flag of the Municipal Police as it relates to those under the Statutory Authority Service Commission with a passion. And I want to thank you very much, Mr. Parker, for that passion in which you continue to show as it relates to driving that ship and flying the flag as we go forward. Thank you for your words of inspiration and encouragement. Ms. Jessica Williams, for that wonderful rendition. You know, we really enjoyed it, and we wish to thank you very much. Well, you know, we all wish we were children again. You know, if we were children, it wouldn't be so tired. You know, the parents do all the work, the children enjoy the fun. So thank you for that song. Oh, I wish I was a child again. Truly. Mr. Kenneth Reno. Keith Reno, sorry. Director of Office of Law Enforcement Policy, representing the Ministry of National Security. Thanks for the efforts of your office through the Ministry of National Security and your pronouncements and your promises. We will keep you to those promises, Mr. Reno, and we will do our part and look after ours. Thank you very much. And what can I say about Kizzy? I know Kizzy a little girl like this. And ever since she has been touching our hearts with wonderful renditions. I thank you for that song, Kizzy. Miss Fidia Isessa, Deputy Mayor, I think your words were timely, very encouraging, based on certain articles in the newspaper.
Above my favorites.
I wish to thank you, and I'm sure it would have been suited for the certain heads. Thank you very much for your inspiring words. My boss. That's my boss. Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Rural Development and Local Government. Thank you for the update. I must say that your utterances were music to our ears.
Yes.
I'm sure a lot of us were happy. An update of what has been happening, because to some extent we have been kept in the dark, especially as it relates to the municipal police going forward and the reform, especially the legislative part of it, because we cannot go forward with legislation. Thank you very much for that update. We are glad to hear that there is some, you know, there's some churning going around, you know, there's some churning, the tide is turning, and we look forward to 2018, and as we say, Municipal Police and 2018 and onwards. I call it Municipal Police Stephen Giant. By and large, municipal police have a great part to play in what is happening in Trinidad and Tobago. All we need is resources, manpower and resources. And we will make a difference. We will make a difference. So thank you very much. I want to acknowledge some of our invited guests. I recognize ACD, Cecil Santana, retired. I want to recognize the former, I met her here as the CEO, acting CEO of San Fernando, Ms. Russo. I understand she's now a PIRO officer. All the spouses who are present, who are the officers of the municipal police and your spouse. You know, the spouse plays a very important part in you on a daily basis, male or female. So I want to thank you for the support that you have given. I thought maybe calling up my officers. I wish, and I thank you for being here supporting this event here. I want to say the best for that. I want to thank maybe to Ms. Cecil, or thank the mayor for allowing us the ambience to be able to use this facility free of charge. I want to thank the organizers who put us together, led by the senior superintendent himself.
Good morning.
just few words, let me say thank you on behalf of my family and I. I want to wish you God's blessing, God's speed, His grace and His mercies, peace, love and prosperity for 2018. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Assistant Commissioner Brian Headley, certainly a passionate vote of thanks. I just read on WhatsApp that following a medical study, doctors have recommended that you engage in at least 3 minutes of exercise before eating, and you will live longer. A word to the wise is sufficient. To bring the curtain down, you're going to call back Ms. Kizzy Huggins, who's going to do for us, have yourself a merry little Christmas. Remember the doctor's advice. Kizzy?
Yes, sir.
Right. So you all can start exercise from now because the next item is dinner. So get up. Kizzy, go ahead.
Welcome to the persons who would have come in after I sang my first song. We are glad to have you here. This is a wonderful event, very well put together, and I want to thank you all for having me here tonight. DJ?
Please stand and help me welcome to the microphone Senator the Honourable Kazim Hossain, Minister of Rural Development.
Thank you very much, Master of Ceremonies. Permanent Secretary, I must say my Permanent Secretary. I leave my wife home, and this is my main person. Mr. Shobas, come on, give a round of applause. She's very hardworking, and I must say, when I took up the job in the Ministry of Local Government, and the government decided to deal with the municipal police, I wanted to deal with it very fast. Permanent Secretary worked with me, that's all Mr. Headley is here, Mr. Huggins, I don't know why Mr. Charles didn't want to come, but I'll bring him. But that was Mr. Santana here, who will take up the slack. Just waiting on the word, Mr. Santana. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I was here earlier on and I had to leave, but I know the permanent secretary will fill in for me and I'm sure she did a good job. She has been at the ministry when I came here a year ago, and we are working on the local government reform and the municipal police. We are going to have the first parcel out, Mr. Headley. We plan the first parcel out, which is the 26 officers. Yeah. Right, we're doing it in San Fernando. And we'll ask senior officers to take part. We'll have a street parade. And we are going to do it in grand style, because I know Mr. Charles Lenton is in grand style. Okay? We want to let people know what municipal police is about. And we must be respected. Because I remember when I started off in the corporation almost 40 years ago, the respect for the police, when we used to say market police and vendor police, that it is for that past. In 2017, I must say, we had the cleanup campaign and I have been around this country and we got PS, we got the full support of all the municipal police. Everywhere. I remember Sandy Grammy was showing up on the motorbike and so on. TTPS guy goes out with her. So yeah, you know, TTPS didn't have that. So how good? But we have it in the municipal police. Now we're taking it to our next level. So ladies and gentlemen, you look beautiful. And I walked in, I smelled the room, the fragrance with the front. I have four ladies who marry me, my wife, two daughters, and my mother, so I know about good things, especially when it comes to ladies. So I want to wish you all good health, long life. Thanks for the support. You all make a lot of sacrifices as officers. When you leave home, you're not sure to come back. And people must respect the job that you do. I will ensure whatever little position that I have, for how long I am there for, because I always say this job is very temporary, I will ensure that the municipal police get the respect that they deserve. But you work very hard. I remember when I was a councillor here and then I became the mayor, I got the full support of the municipal police. Full support. I never had a running one day with you all. And I want to say thank you. And as I said, I want to wish you all good health, long life, and Almighty God bless us. But good health, most important, because I could tell you, 6 months ago I went for a blood test, and everything was good. Pressure, sugar, cholesterol, everything. You see that young lady sitting in the corner there? 6 months after, everything high. Sugar high, very high. Cholesterol, very high. And apparently, yes, you know, I don't eat much. I don't eat nothing at all. But it's the stress of the job. So ladies and gentlemen, take care of your health. Put your family first, your wives, your children, your parents, put them first and put the job after. I know it's hard to say, But I'm watching her close and I see a young lady in the audience, and I know she's very close to her daughters. So you all put your family first. Please, don't end up like you leave home and you can't come back. And husbands, take care of your wives. Because that's the backbone of your house. So, Sakana, I hope you listen to me. If I remind myself first, and then you. So, ladies and gentlemen, I want you to have a pleasant evening. I am glad to be here. And we will work together to build a better Trinidad and Tobago. Thank you very much.
Take care of your health. Put your family first. Thank you very much, Senator the Honorable Kazim Hossain, Minister of Rural Development and Local Government. Let's hear it for my government. Will the driver of vehicle registration number PDH Papa Delta Hotel 2991 attend to your vehicle, please? Again, will the driver of vehicle registration number TDH, end of the official part of this evening's proceedings. You have been a terrific audience. I invite you now to exercise for 2 minutes and go have dinner. Thank you very much.
Outside. Christmas time again, they shouting. Some hanging curtain, some painting. It's Christmas time again, they shouting. Some hanging curtain, some painting. Children hanging up stockings.